Open Unicorn Recorder 1.24.0.0. If this device pops up, we're connected to the Unicorn and you can see the main GUI of the Unicorn Recorder. You can see the control bar with the play button, record button, a setting button. You can see the scope bar where you can modify the amplitude scaling. You can enable or disable Oscar. You can set filters and not filters. So if you click the play button, you can see data is flowing in by the cursor moving from left to right. But without filters, we cannot see good EEG signals yet. By default, if we're working with dry EEG, we apply filters from around 1 to 30 Hz. That's where we find most of the surface EEG. You can see that there's still a lot of noise. This is due to the power line hum. And since I'm in Europe, I will add a 50 Hz notch filter. Now the EEG signals look way cleaner. You can also add a cascading notch filter for 50 or for 60 Hz. This removes not only the 50 Hz noise, also the multiples like 100 Hz or for 60 Hz 120 Hz. And if I sit still now and don't talk, we will see some good EEG. Now I do some app links. You can see big amplitudes, especially in the front channels close to the eyes. I'll clench my teeth. Now you can see EMG artifacts. Now wait until the signal settles again and try to get some alpha. And we can also see some alpha bursts. Okay, so that's how you can use Unicorn Recorder to visualize data and to pre-process it using filters. There are a lot of different filters for different frequency bands. There are possibilities to only apply high pass or only apply low pass filters, or some default bandpass configurations that we use for PCI processing. For EEG, you usually want to use a scaling in between 50 or 100 microvolts, depending on your preferences. And I can also apply Oscar. And Oscar is our artifact removal algorithm. And as you can see, the signals look very clean, and it's really hard to get Oscar into saturation or introduce some artifacts because Oscar cleans them pretty well. So even if I'm clenching my teeth or blinking, the signals are pretty much gone. The artifacts. All right. Then we have a lot of new features in Unicorn Recorder. We have the acquisition tab. In here you can add and remove signals from data acquisition. The Unicorn has 8 EEG electrodes. They are always included in the data acquisition, but you can add or remove additional channels like the accelerometer, the gyroscope, battery level, counter, validation indicator, and the timing channel. So if you enable all of these signals, they will be included in data acquisition, and if you record files, you will have them as additional channels. Or if you send them via network to another application, and if you remove them, they are not included in the data file. You can also switch in between test signal and electrode. Then we have some recording features. The old Unicorn recorder already had CSV logging, so you can store your data in a comma-separated file. And the nice thing about CSV files is that you can import them in almost every programming language, so it's very easy to work with CSV files. You can modify the location where the files will be stored, as well as the file prefix. And the file you're recording will be stored with the file prefix as well as a timestamp. New feature is that we've added a BDF logger. So BDF is a similar file format to EDF, a standardized format for biosignal recordings, with the major difference that it supports 24 bits. And also here you can modify the folder path where we're storing data and the file prefix. So I'll enable both now. And we've added some network interfaces. So with the current version of Unicorn Recorder, we can receive triggers from external applications, and we can send the data synchronized with trigger out to another application, either via UDP or also using lab streaming layer. And then we have some device settings where we can read the hard and firmware version of the Unicorn device we're working with. You can see that there's a Wi-Fi signal on the top right. This one indicates if you have a network interface enabled or not. Then you have the battery level of your Unicorn and the connection state. So right now I've enabled all of the network in and outputs, as well as all the recording options. So if I now press the record button, whatever is displayed on the GUI will also be recorded to a file plus the additional channels. So in the data file, we would have 19 channels, 8 EEG electrodes, 3 channels accelerometer, 3 channels gyroscope, validation indicator, battery level, counter, trigger, and a timestamp showing the delta time between different samples, so we can estimate the jitter. So if I click the record button again, the recording will stop and the recorder goes back to file display mode, or I can completely stop data acquisition. And as mentioned before, data is stored to g.tec, Unicorn Suite, Hybrid Black, Unicorn Recorder. And here we can see some EDF and BDF files that have been recorded. So, as mentioned before, this file by default features 19 channels with 8 channels EEG, accelerometer, gyroscope, counter, battery level, validation indicator, timestamp, and trigger. And you can also load this data in an EDF or BDF viewer, like the EDF browser, or you could also load it in MNE or similar. And here you already see the data is labeled correctly. And we have all of the signals that we've enabled in the data file. And then you can load your EEG in the tool that you prefer. So right now I've showed you how to visualize data, filter data, and record data. So that's usually the case if you want to do some offline processing or just data visualization. Now the next thing, if you would do some offline processing, would be to add some triggers to label your data or to maybe look at ERPs or similar. So that's what I'd like to show you next, and therefore I've prepared a small Python script that I'd like to execute now. And this Python script basically sends a trigger from Python to Recorder, so we could label our data. For instance, right now we could send a trigger and label this data as I'm talking, do not process this data. And if I sit still now and keep quiet, we could label this section as useful EEG or something like that. So this is a very basic example to show you how to send keyboard triggers from the keyboard, from a Python script to Unicorn Recorder. But there are many different stimulus presentation tools available that you could use. From g.tec we have Paradigm Presenter that you could use to send data to Unicorn Recorder. You could write your own stimulus presentation tools. We have an example in the manual for C#. And compiled C# example and a code snippet for C#, a code snippet for Python, and the example I've showed you right now, the code snippets where I'm sending triggers on keystrokes, is also available in the manual. And you would also have these triggers in the file on the last channel, so you can easily do research using that that feature. So the next feature I'd like to show you is that we also have network outputs. Previously we've configured the trigger input to be enabled, the UDP output to be enabled, and the LSL output to be enabled. That's what I'd like to show next, how you could stream data from Unicorn Recorder into another application. And therefore I start the data acquisition again. And with Unicorn Recorder, we install two examples, one for live streaming layer and one for UDP. So we have the live streaming layer receiver. This example is written in C# and should compile out of the box. So data acquisition is running in the background in Unicorn Recorder. And we want to see if we can stream data from the left application to the right application. And we can see that the Unicorn Recorder LSL stream is already detected. And now I just select the stream, press enter, and you can see that we're receiving data. This is again the same format as in the CSV file. The data is serialized and you can easily receive it in your live streaming layer application. So there are many different applications available. I've added a C# example. You can stream in a framework that is supporting live streaming layer. You can write your own Unity code or your own code. Live streaming layer has interfaces for Python, C, Java, almost every programming language. So that's a pretty easy way to send data from Unicorn Recorder out to another application. And I've added another example for the same feature, just instead of live streaming layer, I'm using UDP. And in this case, we're sending data out on a UDP port, and we have to write the destination port that we defined in Unicorn Recorder. Additionally, we have to be in the same network, and then we can click play again, and we can see data is floating in real time again, and we have the same file format again with the 19 channels that we have enabled. All right, and the third example that is installed with Unicorn Recorder is another trigger sender. So we can, in this case, it's working similarly than beforehand with the Python program. I'm just sending triggers automatically from a loop, just to show you how you could integrate that into your own application. So in here, that's we just have a couple of lines C# code, and the most important part is the UDP sending part. So I'm opening a UDP socket and sending data continuously. So you can easily use this project as a starting point for your own application and modify the code. So I'm opening the socket on the correct port and IP address. And now you can see on the right hand side, I'm sending data once a second. I'm sending a trigger. And on the right hand side, on the left hand side, we receive exactly the trigger value that we sent. So you could easily modify this example for earpiece, for instance. All right, and I forgot to mention on the right hand side, we have the signal quality plot where we can see which electrodes have good signals and bad signals. And that's probably also interesting for Oscar. So you can see right now we have some artifacts on the back channels, and Oscar removes them pretty well. And on the right hand side, you can see the underlying signal if the EEG without Oscar would still be fine, or if Oscar is able to correct the signals properly. So even if the signals are corrected to some degree and Oscar shows that it's correcting something, you can see that the EEG looks very nice in the scope. Okay, I hope I could give you an overview about the new features of Unicorn Recorder.